Bulldogs v Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, R. Gray, one vote. Port Adelaide, O. Wines, two votes. Port Adelaide, T. Boak, three votes. And I declare the winner of the 2021 Brownlow Medal is Ollie Wines of the Port Adelaide Football Club.
From 2016 and 2019, captain of the Fremantle Football Club, Nathan Fyfe.
Congratulations, you're rattled. That was awesome. Much appreciated, sir.
And now, please welcome the chairman of the AFL, Richard Goyder.
Well, thank you, Basil and Gil, well done on a great call, and Hamish and Jackie and the whole team at Channel 7, well done on a wonderful night. Well, it was a tough finish for your season on Saturday night, but we congratulate you on becoming the first Brownlow medalist for the Port Adelaide Football Club. Ollie was drafted to the Power from the Bendigo Pioneers with pick 7 in the 2012 National Draft. He learned his first skills in the game at Echuca Football Club, and thank you again this year to every community level club across the country that nurtures our young girls and boys as they begin to play our great game. In the last 2 years, more than ever, community clubs have been so important to our game to keep us together. In Ollie's first game at AFL level, he showed the signs of the player he has become as he collected 24 disposals, one goal and a Rising Star nomination in Port Adelaide's 79-point victory over Melbourne at the MCG. Since that day in 2013, Ollie has entrenched himself as one of Port Adelaide's most talented players and a premier midfielder of the competition. This year, he has risen to new levels. Receiving his maiden All-Australian blazer, Ollie was dominant in the midfield, averaging more than 32 disposals per game across all 22 games. He was magnificent again on Saturday, and we recognise him as our champion player of the 2021 season. So to everyone around the country, and those of you in Perth, please be upstanding. As I propose a toast to our 2021 Brownlow medalist, Ollie Wines. Ollie Wines.
Ollie, congratulations.
Oh, I better have a drink.
Thank you, Richard. Ollie just said, I better have a drink. And I think you've earned it. Oliver, congratulations. I'm not sure what you thought when you made the trip across from Adelaide to Perth, obviously hoping that it might be for something else in mind as well. But you stand here tonight at the start of grand final week in Perth as the Brownlow medalist. How's that sinking in?
Yeah, no, I'm a little bit rattled, to be honest, still. There's so many great players that I still look up to at my age, and they've had tremendous seasons, and a lot of them are obviously playing on Saturday in the biggest game of the year, and I'm extremely envious of them, and I'd love to be in their position, but as you said, it wasn't to be this year, and I know we'll rebound and go again next year.
And we mentioned just a few moments ago at your table, what a count, and what a count to be a part of with, for the very first time in Brownlow medal history, three players polling more than 30 votes on the night. Four with 30 plus, in fact. Four. How incredible.
Yeah, it was a great count. Obviously, Bont, tremendous player, and Clayton, as you saw in the sort of the openings, he's a little bit younger than me, but we played a bit of junior footy together. I played with his brother Mitch, and we came from the same town, so I'm sure the people back in Echuca tonight are up and about, despite only a few being allowed into a pub. They'll be cheering tonight.
And we'll get to Echuca in just a moment, as we must when we tell the Ollie Wines story. But just some numbers for you, Ollie. You polled in 16 games. That is a new Brownlow medal record. You polled in 11 of the last 12 rounds, and your 36 votes tonight equals Dustin Martin's record from 2017. How about that?
Yeah, no, I'm not sure about the numbers. I don't look into the numbers too much, but 36 sounds like a lot, so I'm happy with it, yeah.
And what were you expecting coming here tonight? Everything's so different, as we've said. You're in Perth tonight, it's not Melbourne, no grand final. What were you thinking you could do tonight in the count?
Oh, I think I'd imagined I'd be up around the mark, but as I said before, there were so many guys had great years, and I think the biggest thing for us tonight was, as a football club, I think more than anything, this is a football club award. It doesn't take an individual, it takes a team, a football club, not just a football department, the admin staff, everyone to get someone to this point. And our year obviously didn't finish as we wanted to, but I think we had another really good year. We made the preliminary final, we finished second, so there's a bit to take out of it, but obviously we're not satisfied yet.
We saw Mum at the start of the night, Jane and Tony. Jane's been a huge supporter of yours and possibly, Ollie, the most competitive person you know?
Certainly is, yeah. I'd love to be a fly on the wall, either back in Echuca where Mum and Dad are, or in North Melbourne where my siblings are. I got a Snapchat before of my eldest sister when I got a vote and she was erupting off the couch. So I'm sure they're there tonight looking on, but I think they've been able to get through the last 18 months in Victoria, particularly from football and from what the boys have been able to provide. They lived week to week to the football, to the games, and I think this is credit to them and their commitment to me, and it's a privilege to win it, I guess, in their honour.
It is a family affair, footy. We all know that, and all of the footballers in the room know that it's not just the player themselves. It takes a whole team to be able to get the player to the line. Your family, a lot of different clubs are supported. Maybe just run through who Mum and Dad supported, your sisters and your grands as well.
Yeah, so I think I went for Carlton as a kid because my grandma went for Carlton, but then there was like, Dad went for Geelong, one of my sisters went for Geelong, my elder sister Maddie went for Essendon, my brother went for Richmond, Mum went to Hawthorn because Todd Viney connection and he was coaching there. And my other grandma went for Carlton, so there was a wide variety of teams. No one went for Port Adelaide at that stage, but they're certainly on the power bandwagon now.
Your favourite player was an Echuca boy?
He was, Andrew Walker, yeah. I grew up idolising a local boy who got drafted to Carlton in Andrew Walker, and one of my fondest memories of him is his dad used to be runner for Moama Seniors in the Murray League, and on the way back when I was a young tacker, we used to stop in, get a six-pack and a bit of pork crackle for me. And I used to ring up Rex Hunt and ask about Andrew Walker's stats. And I always got through, like, every week. Rex would tell me Andrew Walker's stats. I was that interested in him. And I think as a young fella from a country town like that, you want to follow your idols, and those guys are the best examples.
So let me get this right. You used to ring Rex Hunt talk back on 3AW.
Yeah, certainly did. Back, I would have been in the early 2000s when Rex was still calling, and I'd get through and talk about Andrew Walker and my blues, and we'd gone away.
I reckon you'll get through to any talk back in the country tomorrow, no problem. Just saying, it's Ollie Wines, I'm here to speak. I'm the Brownlow medalist. It's amazing tonight, obviously, but drafted at number 7, Ollie, in 2012, and it wasn't all great smiles back then. Tell us about draft night.
No, it wasn't. I probably didn't expect to go to Port Adelaide or go interstate from Victoria. I'm very home-orientated person, and I had a really good upbringing with my family, and it was a little bit shocked to go to Port Adelaide, and there was a few tears from mum and dad and myself on the night, but I guess it's only strengthened me to the person I am today, and to be honest, it's the best decision the club could have made for me, and me as a human, and as Boakey said tonight, us as a human rather than a footballer is most important. So I think they've developed me into the man I am today, and I'm very proud of that.
Isn't that nice? It's amazing. Yep. Speaking of humans that you're close to and who've had a big impact on you, you mentioned just Skipper, who we saw honoured tonight, which was magnificent. And what about Ken Hinckley, your coach, but I think even more than that to you?
Certainly is, and not just to me. He's been such a role model for me, and as I said before, there was a few tears in the room when I was drafted to Port Adelaide. It was his first year taking over, and the guidance and the role model he's been for me is so much more than I can imagine, and I owe him so much. And as I said before, this award is more than an individual award. This is a team award, and Kenny's so a part of that. And we've got full faith in the group we've got and Ken's leadership. And despite the bad ending to this year, we know we'll be back next year.
We're on Channel 7, obviously. You've mentioned your captain and your coach. What about the president of the Port Adelaide Football Club?
I know Koshy tried to get over here tonight. He wasn't allowed in. He'd be flat because Eddie wasn't allowed in, but he wasn't either. So he sent me a few messages tonight, and he's been super for our footy club. As I said before, when I was drafted, Ken Koshy and Boakey were the leadership in charge, and what they've done to our footy club and the direction they've turned in is enormous.
Just quietly, I reckon the cash cow's going to be doing somersaults on Sunrise tomorrow morning. What a win. Congratulations.